गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू एंड यू आर वॉचिंग द रेगुलर जीडी सेशन दैट इज रेगुलर जीडी टॉपिक्स अपलोडेड एवरी डे ऑन योर पीडी एजुकेशन एंड यू नो इन एवरी वीडियो आई से जीडी इज अ वेरी सिंपल थिंग नॉट अ डिफिकल्ट थिंग ओनली थिंग इज यू हैव टू प्रैक्टिस इट सो व्हाट टू से दैट पार्ट आई एम डिस्कसिंग हियर एंड हाउ टू से फॉर दैट यू नीड टू basically participate in the group discussion with your PDA and your PDA is conducting GD almost every day online and students all over India join us on that particular discussion. So on the number being provided to you, you can always fill the Google form whenever the slot is available. You will be called for GD and you will be provided the GD opportunity and you can message also on the number which is given. Whenever you have GD for any particular exam, you please get in touch with us. GDs are required in public sectors, placement companies, management courses. These domains are requiring the group discussion. It's only practice. Everybody can do GD. Even if you know English, you do not know English, immaterial, you can score good in GD. That is our perception. Now, the topic I'm going to discuss with you. GD topics are of two types, related to current issues or static issues. Current issues we are covering and static issues both we are covering, and you should know the points with the points being discussed with you, so you should know these points what are provided to you. Now the topic for the discussion today is planning versus implementation. Yes, if this topic is given to you, how you have to start. Okay, good morning friends, my name is Vijayendra and I take the opportunity to initiate the discussion. Friends, the topic for the discussion today is planning and implementation. I am very sure all of us have experienced this problem of planning and implementation. Whenever we want to complete some particular target or objective or project, then first thing is we have to plan for its completion. We have to plan everything, how to do it, in what time you have to do it. And second is execution part, real part, doing part, implementation part. So friends, in my opinion, largely people can make good planning, but then when that comes to implementation part, we normally fail. So planning and implementation, any one component is missing, the project will not be completed, in my opinion. In my opinion, this topic is a very good topic to discuss, and I'm very sure all of us have some points to contribute in the discussion. So I open the house for the discussion. So I invite all of you to give your points. आपने house को open कर दिया, introduction कर दिया, आपने एक direction दे दिया उनको discuss करने के लिए. और अगर आप direction दे दें, if you give the direction and people follow in that direction, you are already you have won the group discussion. You are already the leader. So you give the direction and people will follow in that direction. So this is what you have to do. So you need to find a perspective. Okay, now जब आपने introduction कर दिया उसके बाद आपको enter भी करना है. So friends, planning is basically the think tank part. It is the think tank part. It is basically related to knowledge. Experts are involved in this stage. Expert people are involved in this particular stage. Data and information may be required. Data and information may be required for basically planning. It is said that well begun is half done. So use this kind of phrases. Well begun is half done. So well begun is half done. That reflects the basically importance of the planning. That if you plan well, then almost half job is over, that problem is over. That is what you can do it. Then implementation is the real execution. Execution part. Maximum failures in any project are not because of planning, it is because of implementation. Because for the implementation, what is required is commitment, what is required is discipline, what is required is coordination, what is required is monitoring, what is required is follow up. These things are required. So the good manager, a good manager should manage the show well. Implementation should be really good. This is identification of the resources. In this case, identification of resources. यहाँ पे आप रिसोर्स को आइडेंटिफाई करते हो, कितना पैसा है, कितना टाइम है. यहाँ पे आप बेसिकली यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेस. Utilization of resources. I told you that this project will require 1 crore. Do you have 1 crore rupees? Yes, I have. No, take 1 crore. So if implementation is not good, you will waste it. So utilization of the resources in this part. Workforce is involved in this. Workforce is involved in this. Now you see, after this data, give some kind of interesting example. Friends, planning is basically one part. I know all of we experience that whenever some exam comes, 3 months are left, we plan very well. Every day, till every day we plan. We will study this topic, this topic, this topic. But what happens at the end? We fail in implementation. We do not implement that. We are not in position to maintain the basically planning schedule. So implementation may fail. Friends, I will quote here recent development, new education policy. It is a wonderful. Planning is wonderful. Why? Because the experts were taken into consideration. Kasturi Rangan committee recommendation, you know, ex-ISRO chief. He was the expert, think tank. He gave planning to us. Okay, new education policy will be this. And it was formulated sitting in the center, some experts. But when it comes to implementation, it will go to village level. Unless until it is implemented well, it will not be fructified properly. So any project to be successful, planning should be good, implementation should be good. Friends, I sometimes bother why the projects implemented by government sometimes exceed the time limits and resource money. Why? Because maybe this part is not very well taken care of. And friends, I also know my mother does not plan at all, but she's an excellent executor. She's excellent basically manager. She does not plan how it is to be done, but she implements it. On the other hand, with due respect to my father, he plans the things. Maybe he is not that good in implementation of those plans, that I will do this and all. You can quote example of your father or something like that. I mean, you need to give day-to-day life examples. And your examples will make your point very, very clear, and that will impress the others. So at the end, conclusion, okay friends, we have quite good inputs we got. It's an interesting topic and all of us have given the good inputs. And if I'm to conclude our entire discussion, then in my opinion, everybody agreed that planning and implementation, they are the two crucial points of any project. Unless until both are properly taken care of, project cannot be successful. But yes, we also agreed that majority failures are at the stage of implementation, not planning, because planning is done, it is in the initial phase, and planning is done by experts. So once they do that, then the real job comes by workforce, and to have commitment, discipline, monitoring, that is a real challenge. This is what all of us agree to. Whenever you have to give conclusion, remember always, you are not to say in conclusion anything which people have not said. Because if you say something, then they will object to you, and that will be embarrassing. So you say only whatever been discussed. Number two, conclusion mein new point is not to be added. Already whatever discussed, that you have to add. Number three, conclusion should not be your opinion. Conclusion should be the opinion of entire group. Introduction can be your opinion only, because you are starting it. But conclusion is not your opinion. It is the opinion of entire group. Also, if you want to give your own opinion in conclusion, you have to use this line. Friends, that I believe this is how it is. I hope you understood this topic. So just note these points.